your 11 Insta Weather Plus forecast with Chief Meteorologist Tom Tasselmyer.
For most areas, just another dry and mild final day of winter in the Baltimore area. Unusually mild, but a couple spots are picking up some rain. And you can see the showers are tracking through parts of northern Carroll County now, about to clip Pretty Boy Reservoir in northern Baltimore County. Lighter showers up that way. So far, no signs of any thunder developing in that little cluster of wet weather. To the southeast of Baltimore, on the eastern shore, we've seen a line of showers that occasionally has shown the tendency to try to build up into some thunder. See a lightning strike or two there just to the east of Cambridge, and the showers are drifting north. These are likely developing on the sea breeze that came in with cool air coming in off the ocean to the east, making it to the eastern shore, bumping up against some warmer air and acting as kind of a mini cold front just to the southeast of Baltimore. But in the city of Baltimore itself, no rain just yet. We'll keep an eye to the west to see if any of those showers make it here. But the almanac so far on this 19th day of March indicates dry weather and temperatures 20 degrees warmer than normal. 75 at the airport, 75 at the Inner Harbor. The normal is only 55, and we were oh so close to setting a record, but not quite. Fell short 3 degrees. It's 78 will stand as the record high for this day for yet another year. It goes back to 1918. Almost 5 inches of snow on this day back in 1958. No snow today, though, on this last day of winter. 74 degrees in downtown Baltimore. You see the cooler temperatures north and west toward Manchester, where those scattered showers and clouds are moving through. And then closer to the bay, the temperatures are a couple degrees cooler, especially at Stevensville, where it's 67 degrees right now. 73 down at Fredericksburg, Virginia. 69 at Salisbury, and only 60 on the beach at Ocean City with the cool air coming in off the ocean. Western Maryland is mild. Temperatures tonight will stay above normal, 46 to 56 the spread. Isolated evening showers and then some fog developing after midnight into tomorrow morning. Here's the weather pattern across the nation, and it's a split decision. If you're in the eastern half of the country, you're enjoying an early spring. High pressure on the Gulf Coast sending the jet stream all the way up into Canada around Hudson Bay and then east out of eastern Canada. But in the west, it's a big, powerful storm dropping lots of cold all the way down to the Mexican border. Very cold and stormy here west of the Rockies and unseasonably mild east of the Rockies. And with this pattern, the weather systems don't move very quickly. It's not a west to east flow carrying systems rapidly across the country. This up and down high amplitude flow means systems crawl very slowly. So all of the stormy weather is going to remain out west. Blizzard warnings in parts of Montana, winter storm warnings all the way down into southern Arizona and New Mexico. The mountains down here are going to pick up several inches of snow. While in the east, that southerly flow of air sends mild temperatures all the way up into southern Canada. So we're on the warm side of things for now. After some fog tomorrow, we'll get some sun, temperatures in the 70s again, and a chance for a late day shower or thunderstorm. East to perhaps southeast winds on the bay tomorrow with waves averaging about a foot. Mild in the mountains, a thunderstorm tomorrow, and then partly cloudy on Wednesday. Eastern shore locations, temperatures in the 70s, unless you're right on the shore of the bay where it'll be just a touch cooler. Slight chance for a storm tomorrow. Lower eastern shore, a decent sea breeze will keep temperatures on the beach much, much chillier, but inland well into the 70s, although you'll probably have to dodge a couple scattered thunderstorms Tuesday and Wednesday. Spring officially begins at 1:14 in the morning, highs in the low 70s, both Tuesday and Wednesday. Some fog to start the day Wednesday and Thursday, but that'll burn off to some afternoon sun. Friday will get close to 80. Over the weekend, a chance for some showers with highs still well above normal.